WordPress is still a thing, okay? I've been working with it since version 1, and I can tell you the ins and outs, the good, the bad, the ugly, but why it's not going anywhere anytime soon. It's infinitely customizable, free software that you can use to build websites. Back when I started using it, it was very blog driven. It wasn't really intended to do any of the things that it's doing now. But because there's such a massive open source community that surrounds WordPress, anything that you need to get accomplished within the WordPress environment can generally be handled by something that already exists, like a plugin or some external service. WordPress is open, it's extensible, It can communicate and talk with social media and Google, and it's quite incredible. There's thousands of developers all working on different things for WordPress. It's obviously spun out into WooCommerce, which is WordPress's built-in e-commerce situation, which is, you know, I'd say quite a direct competitor of Shopify. The reason why WordPress stinks is because it always needs to be maintained. It always needs to be updated and upgraded. There's always security patches. If you let things go, chances are there's gonna be some hack or some malware or some terrible thing that sneaks in the back door of some old plugin on your WordPress website and causes your site to blow up. I've seen very terrible things happen to WordPress websites if you let them go. My advice right out of the gate with that is don't let your WordPress website age. Don't let it just sit there and collect dust. If it's important to you, you just have to at least keep the scripts and the plugins updated. And over time, you work to replace plugins with new plugins or things that exist within the themes themselves. Plugins are great because they extend the functionality of WordPress, but plugins are also open holes. If a developer stops developing the plugin that you're using and, you know, some hacker finds a way into your website through that plugin, that's an exploit. And those hackers come in and they do whatever they do. Normally they would insert advertising or some Viagra spam. I've seen like a million different things that can happen. They take over your website in a terrible way. They deliver ads, whatever the case. Don't want to let your WordPress website age. So you'd want to get on some kind of a maintenance program or maintenance plan to keep your plugins and your themes and your scripts updated. So there's a lot of things that you could do as far as hosting goes to get your site backed up regularly, because that's a huge important factor. Back in the old days, it was like I had to back everything up manually, and you know, you would get the database, you would get all the files, you would get everything, like 8,000 files being downloaded. The connection would break sometimes. It was a whole to do. Places like WP Engine managed WordPress hosting make it so that backups are seamless and they happen automatically every single day. And if you go in and you mess something up, you can easily reverse those changes back to the previous save. So every day, every week, every month, or on demand, if you know you're gonna do an upgrade or an update, then you can easily make a backup, do whatever you have to do to the live site. If it doesn't work out, within seconds, your site will be back up and running seamlessly and smoothly. This is not the way it used to be. Listen to this advice. The only thing that your host should do if you have a WordPress website is host WordPress websites, not all kinds of other websites. You don't need a big old cPanel and all this extra jazz. Like Bluehost is terrible. GoDaddy hosting, awful. I've seen so many different platforms over the years, and none of them, specifically for WordPress, are as good as WP Engine. So that's a strong recommendation for using them. Another thing with WordPress to understand is that design is really easy and nice to make, like, visually attractive websites and theme things the way you want to theme things and place things the way you want to place them. I use a theme called ProTheme. It's by theme.co. And God, if you look at the inside of what's going on inside of ProTheme and compare it to the ridiculousness of the old days of WordPress, where I would have a block of code and it would be all these little short codes and HTML and CSS, and the output on the page would never be what you had in there. You always had to do something to like trick it into looking sort of like what you wanted to look at. Like, ProTheme solves all of those problems. ProTheme puts the design into your hands, and it allows you to output whatever you want with all the calls and all the database driven stuff. In addition to the visuals, ProTheme has it figured out. It's a block style drag and drop functionality right into WordPress. So if you want text, you take a block, you pull it in and you place and format your text, you add colors, you do whatever you have to do. Same thing with images, backgrounds, videos, integrating social, integrating Google, integrating, you know, feeds for products, whatever you need to get done, all the blocks and all the way that you can like work inside of WordPress and customize it. It's just incredible if you know what you're doing or if you have someone that knows what they're doing. It's just, there's no end to it. And so that's the reason why WordPress is still a thing. For me, working from version one to today and all of the changes that have happened with WordPress, I could say that I'm still in love with it. So if you have a WordPress problem, whatever it is, chances are I've seen it, I can fix it, I can help you, I can help guide you, I can help guide your team in getting whatever it is that you have resolved. In some cases, we can be brought on to go ongoing support for WordPress, or in some cases, we could just fix your problem and you can be on your way. So if you need help with WordPress in any way, shape, or form, I've got it. WordPress 1 through WordPress 5, I think we're on 5.8. So whenever you see this video and anything that's happened between then, that's a lot of things. I've been there for the whole ride. So give me a yell, Michael Baker Digital. Good luck out there.